the breakthrough that we've achieved is we can now generate fully in a petri dish stomach tissue. And this is important because in the case of people with stomach disease, like peptic ulcer disease, or ultimately people who get stomach cancer, we can now study the very early stages of that disease and then use this as a research tool to try to identify therapies to prevent stomach disease. Up until now, there's been no good way to study stomach diseases in humans. Human stomach is very different than the stomach of other animals. The different cells and their structure and arrangement in our stomach tissues in a dish were virtually identical to that we would find in the stomach normally. We're already testing the ability of these human tissues to, for example, plug up holes that are made experimentally in the stomach of a mouse. And early results look promising, that these might be able to be used in grafts, maybe to patch holes that are caused by peptic ulcer disease. There's a certain cell type in the stomach and in the intestine that help explain the reason why bypass surgery can cure type 2 diabetes. And now with the tools in hand that we have, namely human stomach organoids and human intestinal organoids, we can now really try to get at the molecular reason for the curing nature of gastric bypass. What we're now able to provide people are the tools and the training to use these very specialized cell types and to generate pluripotent stem cells from patients with various genetic disorders, that we can now use these cells to actually, as a research tool, to study those genetic disorders in tissues that we grow in the laboratory. We are looking at the impact of the most common stomach bacteria that causes disease, H. pylori. In our collaboration with Yana Zavros, we've now been able to really look at the very earliest stages of this human disease using human stomach tissue. Because of the collective abilities of all these individuals, I think this was this made the study possible. Not only can we generate stem cells from patients with various genetic diseases, it's now possible to correct those genetic diseases and grow healthy cells, ultimately for transplantation and corrective cell therapies. While research takes a long time, we're at a really critical junction now where we're really going to start seeing some important therapeutic milestones in the future, both through new drug discovery and longer-term replacement tissues for therapy.